Last week, we brought you the story about how grain is having to compete for space on barges and rail cars, due in no small part to the massive size of this year's crop.
Well, October is here, and that means we have the first look from the USDA on the harvest and just how big it will be. Neil Melancon has all the details in this week's Bottom Line.
The Bottom Line is brought to you by the Cotton Board, strengthening the fiber of our industry.
Well, things are moving in the fields in the Midwest, and so we're getting started to see some initial numbers on this year's crop. The short story is that October's supply and demand report showed a jump in grain from September, but not quite as much as expected. As a reminder, these numbers are still just an estimate, and we won't get final numbers on these grains until next year. With that said, our production this year is coming in at 174 bushels per acre. That's up 3 from September and just slightly below the average trade guess prior to the report. Beans are in much the same boat, with the trade almost nailing it exactly. Again, beans are up from the September estimate as well. World supply-wise, we're running up the numbers. Again, not quite as much as the trade expected. Corn didn't move much at all from September, and the average trade guess was almost a bushel and a half over what USDA reported. Beans, on the other hand, were largely in line with the guess, with about 100,000 tons short there only. It's pretty much what was reported in September. This is likely a sign of cutbacks in bean acreage in South America coming up, but of course, it's still very early down there. Finally, let's take a look at where we are in Louisiana, where we can clearly say it's a record-setting year. For corn, we're at 180 bushels per acre again, no change from last month, but still a record crop. Beans jumped up 2 bushels per acre as the later harvest has come up. That's 5 bushels per acre above the record. In both corn and beans, by the way, both records for yields were set last year. The bottom line here is something I mentioned in passing last week. The trend has been going like this. Every time we see an increase in the October report for the crop, it jumps up again in November. So the likelihood is that even with this increase, it's going to get even bigger. And of course, guys, South America has started to pick up on what's going on here in the United States, and we're seeing a little bit of a cut in the acreage down there as well.
I see a lot of pointy hats and crystal balls.
Yeah, it's either
this.
Harvest time or Halloween, something. One
yeah.
or two.
Thanks, Neil.
Well, on that note, that does it for this edition of This Week in Louisiana Agriculture.
Be sure to join us next week with Neil Melancon. We'll look at consumer prices for food and when we'll get a break at the cash register.
Until then, you can watch all of the stories from this show or past shows on our website, twilatv.org, and keep up with what we're doing on Facebook and Twitter.
For all of us here at This Week in Louisiana Agriculture, thank you for watching, and we hope to see you again right here next week.